I'm Natalia Bonner. Welcome back. All right, I'm having a lot of fun here doing a bit of machine quilting with rulers, and I just had to share that with you. So today I'm using my mini 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler, and I'm playing around just in a square quilt block, but I'm going to be playing around with some straight lines. Now I'm playing around with spacing, but without doing any markings, just using the markings on my mini 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler. So let's hop over here to my machine and let's get quilting. So to quilt these lines, we're going to be working with 1 inch and 1/4 inch spacing, just using the mini 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler. So from the needle position to the outside of your ruler foot, and this is a standard on all ruler feet that I have seen, it measures 1/4 inch from there to there. So I have designed my machine quilting ruler so that these markings here on the ruler are based off of your needle position. So the first straight line that we're going to be quilting today is going to be the 1-inch line. To quilt this line exactly 1 inch here from the side, I'm going to need to travel over across my ditch to the 1-inch point. Now I know I'm at the 1-inch point because I'm lining up this 1-inch marked line on my ruler right there on top of my ditch. So I'll line that ruler up there, use gentle pressure both here on my ruler and also the machine as I engage the machine and glide right next to it. So I've stitched that first line all the way up to the top of my block. Now this design, I'm quilting it here in a block, but it would also be awesome in a border. It's a great way to create interest. Once I reach the opposite side, now I'm going to travel over, moving over just 1/4 inch. Now I know I'm at 1/4 inch spacing because the side of my ruler right here is right next to my line. And remember, it's 1/4 inch from your needle to the outside of the foot. So again, I'll use gentle pressure, line up now the side of my mini 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler. So by lining up the side of the ruler on top of my previous stitch line, I know that my spacing is going to be 1/4 inch. So I'll engage the machine, use gentle pressure, and stitch that 1/4 inch spaced line. Now when I get down to the bottom of the block, I'll travel along my ditch. Notice how I stop with my needle in the down position each time I adjust my machine quilting ruler. This helps prevent my machine from moving or creating any crazy stitches. It looks here like I need to move over just a little bit more. Now again, I'll line up those markings and repeat this process until I have filled in this block completely. I love how that design turned out. It's such a great way to, you could use it in borders, you could use it as a background, you could use it in sashing, or even like I've done here, you could use it as a block design. So play around with the markings on your machine quilting rulers. The possibilities really are endless. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I'll be back soon with another fun video.